concept is that you use the high visualization of games, which we know from tablets, smartphones, and so on, but we use them to for serious issues that have to do with technologies and circular economy, and in the long run, you have more informed citizens.
So, technically speaking, serious games are games which are engineered for a purpose other than mere entertainment. It's becoming more and more like a decision support system than just a game, so that you train and you gain knowledge out of it. The nexus is could be described as a network of interactions between different sectors: water, energy, food, climate, and so on. The problem is, so far, people have been thinking in their own field, in their own silo. Nobody actually knows what's happening inside it and what are the consequences of tweaking something in energy on the rest of the system. So the interest of serious games is this idea of tweaking something in the system and get the model of it, giving us what are the consequences on all the rest of the picture. And then this way we can start understanding and exploring these uncharted territories. At the moment in NextGen, we are looking at case studies. We're looking at case studies like Athens, we're looking at Costa Brava. We're also having a look on Gotland. We are trying to make a toy model of this imaginary place. And we're trying to get what are the main thing you can act upon on this toy model, on this toy town. And then we are zooming out from the town, the location, to the region. So we are having basically two areas of effect: the local level at the town level and the regional level. We do a simplified model to first ascertain if the principles hold. Then we can develop from there. You could have anybody using the serious game, depend who you design it for. It could be designed for school children to learn a couple of principles, could be designed for engineers to further their understanding of some complex process. More interesting, the Department of Energy was traditionally isolated from the department, let's say, of water. And these two departments haven't been speaking to each other for years, for example. So if you train a policymaker through, let's call it a serious game, perhaps they could together, when they come on the same system, have conflicting goals or objectives, but have to answer an overarching goal. And from this over, they have to optimize it. And in order to do that, they need to speak to each other and they need to optimize the way they work together as an overall process. So this is the best gain that I'm hoping people would get from a serious game.